right. Greed works.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to episode 30 of Let's Play Wall Street Raider. I'm RakeM, your host. Today, we are continuing our plan to take over the oil industry and to contribute as much cash as possible to maximize our investments in all of our companies. The challenge right now is getting through the disbursement of all this cash. We have cash in a lot of places that needs to be invested. And since we have stocks everywhere now, rather than put money in new industries, you know, the only industries that we're not in are small ones. So the challenge is to invest as much of this cash as possible. The interest rate going up is going to help in that the bond prices will become more affordable. So we'll put more money into government bonds as soon as the price comes down below 100. You may notice that the interest or the stock index is down over 20% in the last couple of months since the interest rates started going up. Oil is now down to 75 and is continuing to slide in the downward direction. Gold, which was up above 1,000, has now started to backtrack with the increase in the interest rate. And silver was all the way down to 11 before going back up to where it is now. We're staying out of wheat and corn because we are too busy with our stocks to pay close attention to those bushel prices. So right now we're just going through all the stocks that we own, and we're putting as much money into them as we can. But since the bank has $9 trillion on hand, we're going to go ahead and put some of that into consumer loans and mortgages. And I think about $5 trillion is about what we want to do. So I'm going to go ahead and buy those. Okay, and we don't want anything in the footwear industry, so we'll just go ahead and sell off Payless. Okay, so we have a bunch of bankruptcies that we need to situate, and we have a couple of industries that we want to get back into, but we don't have a place to put it. All of our insurance companies have 13 stocks each, and we need to keep two slots open for them to buy and sell additional stocks. So it's time to create or buy a new insurance company. And once we have the fifth one, we should be good for a good long time. We may add a sixth one if we decide to enter every industry in the game, which 5 years from now we may want to do, since we'll have even more cash then than we do now. So, the next thing I want to do is I want to go ahead and find another insurance company to acquire. Public, but he has some stocks. But these are all minor factors, so we should be able to pick them up fairly easily and do something with them. So I am going to buy Tokyo Marine and Fire, and if I merge him with SunTrust, I will collect the value of my options. All of these will be canceled or cashed out. And since the stock price is down, that's fine, actually. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to buy Tokyo. Okay, and the challenge at this point, really, it's not about taking over the oil industry. That's easy. The hard part is multitasking and taking care of everything else while we do that. So basically we have to hit all of these stocks, or try to, before ZDNet's ready to take over that industry. Alright, so we're just just going to try to get through all these as quickly as we can. All right, Tokyo needs $15 billion. So let's start off by doing that. Actually, I'm going to give it 20. So he is, grossly incompetent. So we need to change the managers, increase the R&D rate, and we need to cancel his swaps. So let's start by canceling swaps. All right, we'll make the R&D 8%. Change the managers. Set the growth rate to -1. And we'll eliminate a dividend if he has one. But he doesn't. Okay. So let's take care of these stocks that he owns. First of all, with TCOM, we need to merge him into Nortel. Okay. Wow, look at these guys. They've all got major credit. But that's fine. Have Nortel buy 3Com. And liquidate him. Alright, and we need to pay down or pay off our debt, so we need to give him. Let's give him $11 billion. And we need to split him again, but let's see if we need to make any other changes. So he's reasonably competent, 8%, growing at 60, so all that looks fine. Just need to scale up his dividend to 227, 228. And then we need to go deal with the bankruptcies. All right, so still going up. Our returns are still going up. So let's just split him. Let's go over to the bank and deal with the bankruptcies, and then we'll come back to this insurance company. And once again, we sold some assets before we could get over there to cancel it. All right, so let's start with Dillard's. He's super small. And it looks like we got three entries here, and we all want to put them all under soft. So have soft buy up Dillard's and the other one, Broadway Stores, I think it was. All right, so don't think we need to do anything else here. We're still mediocre, so 12% is fine, expansion rate's fine. And our net worth is now at $26 a share, and we're making money, so we can give them a dividend. Okay, back to the bank. Alright, so Exide Corp. Auto parts, which we've been staying out of because it's kind of small. Returns are good, but it's just too small. We've got some in, let's just deal with Subway. Hang on. We have Darden and there's Subway, so we'll have Darden buy him and liquidate him. And no debt, so that's good. Expanding like crazy, so I don't think we want to make any other changes there. We're still competent, 8%. Oh, that's good. All right, back to the bank. All right, so Riverside Health will probably go into Concentric. Yep. Okay, no debt to pay down, so that's fine. Back to the bank. All right, Suzuki Cycles. Bill and Hal here, so Suzuki Cycles and GameTech. We need to buy and liquidate both of those. I don't know why it does this every once in a while. It takes forever to come back. Alright, so International GameTech. I think it's IGMT, but I'm not sure. IGMT. Alright, let's liquidate them both. I just picked up GE Appliances. Alright, so let's buy the bonds back and pay off the loan. Okay, back to the bank. All right, Eddie Bauer. And we don't have anything else in here. Returns are great. Look at those returns. So we want to reform him and so we need to have the insurance company buy him and give him some cash. So Tokyo Marine and Fire. Let's see how much he needs. He needs, let's give him $2 billion. If you hit the right button. All right, so he's got $1 billion cash. Let's see what we need to do. We want to grow 60% while the returns are this high, and we want to set our R&D to 8%. And our dividend to 81 cents. Yep. Now we'll split him. And once again, the bankruptcies are coming real, real fast. So I just want to see how much cash he has now. Okay, $23 billion. So we can add more to him. Let's split him too. Let's go back to the bank and start clearing it out. This may be a while before this slows down with all the new interest rate swaps in the mix. So I think Best Foods was one of the ones we were going to keep. So let's move him over to Tokyo and merge it with Tyson here. And I know we own 50%, but who owns the other? Okay, it's public. All right, so let's have the Tyson buy the rest of it. Okay, and buy Best Foods. Contribute Tyson to Best. And liquidate Tyson. All right, so Best needs another 500, let's call it 800 million, so that he can expand. All right, we'll make this, let's see, returns aren't that great, so let's make it 10. All right, so have Tokyo give him 800 million. Will grow at 10%. All right, back to the bank. All right, Genesco is in footwear. We're not interested in footwear. And we're not interested in Nike either for the same reason. Gas and electric. All right, so we need to give him some more money again. So let's give Southern California Ed $7 billion. Shot up fast. And the stock index is down even further now. Alright, so we're looking for, there he is. Oh look, there's two of them. Alright, so we'll merge those two in as well since we're still under the 20% market share that we want. Money. So let's give him another $20 billion. Do I want to make it that much? No, let's give him 16. Driving down our earnings, but with that high dividend and this much growth, he's not going to last long at that rate. Now if PG&E starts doing the same thing, then we're in trouble, but just this one guy, he won't last long. OK, Okay, so 15% on the R&D. Everything else is fine. All right, we need to split him again. All right, back to the bank. What stock does he have? He's got Dr. Pepper, which is in beverage, which we want. Shishido is in household and personal products. And I think we want to get rid of the bank. Well, there's no reason to keep the bank. Unless he has stocks we want. Well, he's got a lot of stocks. 100% of all of them, too. Alright, let's look. Alright, so 16, 26, 36. We have 36% of the market if we do it right now. I mean, he's a bargain. He is a bargain. And this is a small industry, so I think we'll go ahead and take it. Let's give Shanghai Refrigerator. Let's see, he's gonna need probably 20 billion. We can always give it back if we don't use it. Okay, now, got a great return, and we're reasonably confident. So let's up our R&D to 8%. Let's cancel the swaps. All right, 8%. And I think we want to give them a dividend, and the growth rate needs to be 12%. Matter of fact, let's make it 15. We can do more than that, actually. So we're making 40. So let's make it 25. All right, and our R&D needs to be 279. And let's split him. All right, we're going to lose money this quarter, but next quarter we should start making money again. Okay. Let me just check on the bank, make sure he's not drowning in bankruptcies. It's getting close. He's got 8 of them. All right, so Club Med, let's put him with MGM if MGM's not big enough. No, he's pretty big. And he's at a, oh, that's Trump. That's right. That's right. MGM was getting close to his target price. Let's double check. No, he's not there yet. He needs to get up to 220. I guess we just had it split off. He must have been higher earlier. Yeah, so he got all the way up to his target price, which was 414. And then the interest rate went up and this went down. what I would like to have in this game is I would like to have a buy-sell queue to where, rather than have to keep track and then catch these when they hit the right prices, I can just put in, okay, this stock I want to buy when it hits this price. And then as soon as that stock hits that price, the order is executed. Or, you know, conversely, if I have a stock and I want to sell it at a certain price, I can just put it in a queue that says, when this stock hits this price, I want to sell it. You know, I mean, you can do that in the real world. I would love to have that in this game. But unfortunately, you're required to constantly be watching, you know, 70 stocks all at once, or however many it is. You know, the ones you own plus the ones you want to buy. And I'd really like to see that feature added to this. In 20 years, you'd think it would already be there, but it's not. So, anyway, for what it's worth. Alright, so I think what we want to do is we want to put in with Trump here. Put Club Med in with Trump. Alright, so let's see what Trump's got. He has enough. Trump needs more money again. Let's give him $1 billion. And split him. Okay. Back to the bank. Owns him, and I think we had decided to keep him. So we need to go to Tokyo. Actually, I know what the symbol is. Let's see what neck peripherals needs. He needs $3 billion. So let's give him that. All right, he's reasonably competent, so we'll make his R&D 8%. He's making a profit, so we'll set his dividend to 37. We'll set the growth rate to 60. Okay, back to the bank. All right, here we own Dr. Pepper and A&W for a 9% share. And Pepsi's growing like crazy, and Coca-Cola's in bad shape. So let's see who owns Dr. Pepper, because I don't know. Okay, so that's Deutsche. And he's a little overpriced. He's worth 13 and he's selling for 21. I think we need to kill his dividend. And we can buy a significant market share here. All right, I'm going to buy all of Dr. Pepper and A&W. And then I'll grab all these ones that are under 100% over here. Merge them all together and give them to Tokyo. Alright, so... I'll offer 28% to start. Okay, let's try 32. This again. 32. Oh. Okay, 5. Now 32. What are you talking about? He just considered 28. Stock price came down, so let's try this again because it's only 5% now. Let's make it 36 this time, and they accepted. Okay. All right, now buy ANW. Contribute him to Dr. Pepper. So we want to buy Peak, Shasta, don't know what that one is, but we want to buy them. Alright, let's contribute these three to Dr. Pepper and then liquidate them. To 18% now. So let's give him 16 billion, buy everything back, and then he can buy the rest of the stocks that he needs. And I didn't cancel the swaps quick enough. Let's give him another 8 billion. All right. So, what else do we want to buy here? Well, they've all gone up. So, let's buy whatever this one is. And if this one drops back down around 100, then we'll buy it too. This has gone down to zero because everybody's growing huge. All right, so we'll pay off the bonds. Okay, we're very incompetent, so we need to set our R&D to 16. And I don't think we want to grow right now until everybody exhausts their credit. And we'll eliminate the dividend since we're losing money. Of course, we already did, so that's fine. All right, so 16, growth rate of 0. And that's good. Now when our management comes up, you know, we can try to grow a little larger. If we pick up Coca-Cola, we'll add him in. But until Pepsi runs out of credit, basically we're handcuffed. Now we could freeze him, but we want him to have more debt, especially with the interest rate this high. Speaking of which, it's time to have our insurance companies buy bonds. And I need to buy some bonds and give them to Tokyo. Okay, so I'm going to contribute Dr. Pepper to Tokyo. Now I'm going to buy some bonds. There it is. Wow, look at that price. I'm going to buy all the bonds there are. Alright, so this is going to take a little while, so I'll fast forward while I buy all these bonds, and I'll be back as soon as I'm done. I'm going to contribute those to Tokyo, and he can use the income from those bonds to purchase any other stocks that he needs. 4 trillion worth of bonds. And we may need to change his bank. Get rid of that other bank that we've got. But we want to get rid of these stocks first. So Canadian National Railway, I think we're staying out of railways. Nope, we got Union Pacific. But he's at a high premium, so let's just sell him off. Okay, Ameritrade. I know we have something there. Nico. He's at a high premium too, so we don't want to buy him. Okay, so let's sell him. Jaguar. Also at a high premium. Yeah. Also at a premium. We got a big market share here too. This is textiles, nope, retail apparel. Let's see. We could buy Ann Taylor and then buy his assets and sell him off because we don't care what happens to him. Assets does he have? 4 billion. Alright, let's go to Tokyo. Buy Ann Taylor. Alright, Tokyo has enough cash that he can donate to Ann Taylor. We'll make it 6 billion. Have Ann Taylor buy the assets from Gap. And we'll take 4,000. All right, so reasonably confident, so we'll make it 8%, I think. guys are spending a lot on R&D. Let's make it 12%. And grow at 30. Well, no. We're too big a market share to grow that fast. 12 is fine. So 12, and we'll give them a dividend too. So dividend needs to be 67. Alright, and let's split it. Alright, now we can sell off the bank. Alright, so we gotta get Shishito quick. Or not at all. Alright, so we'll have Amway. Wow, look at his stock price. Let's buy his assets. Alright, now we need to give him 7 billion. Now we need to sell off Deutsche. Okay, before we go any further, let's have the other insurance companies with lots of cash buy bonds. So starting with Zurich. Alright, and I'm going to go ahead and have the other two insurance companies with lots of cash buy bonds as well, and then I'll be right back. See, we're only able to buy 50 bonds at a time now, and the reason why is because we basically bought up all of the government's debt that there is. You're only allowed to buy 1% of the outstanding or unsold bonds each transaction without moving the price. And by moving the price, you only move the price for the single transaction. So, you know, once you make, you know, like, let's say I were to put in 5,000 here. Okay, the price I would get would be huge. Okay, instead of 56, it's going to go all the way up to 100. Okay, now that only applies to my purchase. Once I buy them, it'll go all the way back to the original price of 56.18. Okay, and since this isn't a big transaction, I'll just go ahead and show you. Okay, I bought 5,000 for 5,027. Okay. And if I go to buy bonds now, it's all the way down to 25. So, to show you what the government's debt is, let's see. Here it is right here. National debt, $27 trillion. Okay. Now, it doesn't tell you how much of that is owned, but pretty much all of the long bond. Now, we can probably buy short bond, although I don't know what the price is right now. 95, see? Big difference. Okay, but there's only, let's see, we've got 2884 times 100, so 203,000, you know, $203 billion worth of bonds. is all we can buy, and we'd have to pay this price for it. Of course, the return is pretty good, so I'm going to go ahead and buy all of them, and it's going to take a while, but I'll put the fast-forwarding, instead of on double speed, I'll make it like 32x, because at this rate, it's going to take a while to buy them all. But I'm going to go ahead and do that, and I'll be right back. Okay, that's pretty much all the bonds that the government has. We can buy another 5,000 here if we want to, but, and just to show you what it does to the price, it moves it all the way up to 170, but it's just for this purchase. Once I make the purchase, the regular, you know, the bond price is going to be $95.23, so I'm not going to say yes to this one. But now the bank has $7 trillion in bonds. There they are. And these ones are going to fluctuate a lot because of their original interest rate when they were issued. Okay, so when you reach those 10-year and 20-year milestones for these bonds, it's always great. It's great when the interest rate is low at the time that they're issued, because the bond price will fluctuate a lot more. And it's not so much for buying and selling of bonds that you want that to happen. It's for the fluctuation in the stock price based on the net worth of the company. Because the more this number fluctuates, especially if you have a lot of bonds, the more your net worth fluctuates, and as a result, the stock price. So you end up making a lot more on your options and buying and selling of the stock if you want to do it that way. So basically, when the interest rate is up, you buy it back, and when it's low, you sell it off. Because you can make a lot of money just buying and selling 10% of your company whenever that happens. Okay, so let's see. Silver dropped all the way below 10, and gold has gotten up despite the interest rate, which is nice. So we can pay back some of our loan here. And if silver drops below 10 again, I will have Berkshire Hathaway buy futures and physical silver. Okay, so who still has cash? That's the question. And Irish still has a lot of cash. Zurich, Berkshire has cash. Hartford and Swiss, they all have a little bit of cash. So with the interest rate this high, it's time to go look and see if there's corporate bonds to be had. And let's see how many open slots we've got. So that's 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. So we got one open slot for SunTrust. Let's go see if there's any bonds of significant value to be bought. Here's one for $30,000. One down here for $45,000. Okay, so there's a few. Of course, some of them are going broke because of the swaps and whatnot. Alright, so let's buy the ones for Cisco. Okay, and Irish. Actually, let's start with Hartford since he has the fewest, or is the smallest. So he's got two that are in default. And so 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. So let's get one more. And I'm just going to get one of these A credit rating ones, so Boeing. All right, Swiss, that's 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. So we'll get one for him too. Irish. All right, so he needs quite a few. He's only got four. So I will buy some bonds for him, and I'll be right back. Now let's go back and see how many Zurich has. Okay, that's 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. So we only need to buy one for him. And so we'll buy Citigroup. Okay, now we need to go back to the bank and deal with the bankruptcies. Because we have a bunch now. Alright, so Fluor Corporation. We will merge him with Santa Fe. And we need to give Santa Fe more money. Need to give him $3 billion. Okay, Kaiser Aluminum. We already have a good market share here, but he's only 1%, so Metals looks like it's ready to buy too, but let's just buy him. Newmont is going to need more money too, so all right, so let's give him $4 billion. And we need to split him. And our return's still great, so we're going to keep growing at that 45% rate. All right, back to the bank. McDermott is in oil service, so we'll put him with Rowan. Same thing with Diamond Offshore. And we need to give him $3 billion. Back the growth down to 45% and split him, but otherwise we're going to leave him the same. All right, Kobe Steel will put with Nucor. And let's give him another $3 billion. Alright, the antitrust between Home Base and Home Depot, and we lost. Okay. Alright, you're still going at 45, which is fine, because we're so small. Still very capable, so we'll leave the rest the same. All right, case, heavy machinery. So we'll put him in with Daewoo. And Taiwan synthetic rubber just got a major breakthrough, so that's good. So we need to give him another 1,500. All right. We don't need to grow negative, and we need to increase our R&D. So we're currently mediocre. So let's set this to 12. Growth rate. 10, and if we're making money, we'll give it a dividend, and we are, so we'll set it to 46 cents, okay, back to the bank. Look at this one. That's where Santa Fe is. So we'll buy him and liquidate him. Okay, and we'll split Santa Fe also. Skoda and LGI into Nissan. All right, let's give them another $4 billion. Sell drugs. And we don't have anything else in here, so it's time to get Tokyo involved. Alright, I think I need to check and see where we are on the runtime here. Okay, before we mess with any more bankruptcies, we've been going for over an hour now, so let's just check in on ZDNet, and we'll come back and finish with the bankruptcies next time. So we're down to 27%, and we almost have a 50% market share, and these prices are down, and these returns are down. So I think we want to back this off now to 45%, and just keep going until he gets down. 15% or less is where we want to go. So So let's back this off to 45. Oh, did I hit the wrong one? Okay. Let's see where we are. We still got plenty of cash. All right, so we're going to end here. Thanks for joining me. I know this stuff isn't always that exciting, but just keep in mind that our net worth is going to go up and down and up and down like a yo-yo along with the interest rate. And we're going to be selling when the interest rate is low and buying back when the interest rate is high. But again, everything's going according to plan. Everything looks good. The only thing that I would change would like to see the silver get up to 20 and sell that off. But everything else is going pretty good. So thanks for joining me. Hope you enjoyed the episode. Come back next time. We'll continue where we left off. And looks like we're getting real close to taking over the industry. So hopefully it'll be next episode. Not sure if it will be or not, but hopefully it will. And until then, this is RakeM saying, have a good one.